Alright, hello everyone, and welcome back to my Skyrim Mod Spotlight series, where today we are having a look at the Half Moon Cottage Home, which is being made by user Akkad. And what this glorious little piece of work looks to add into the game is an absolutely gorgeous, beautiful, cozy little cottage just to the south of the Half Moon Mill. And this place is truly magnificent. I love this little player home, as not only does it just look beautiful, but it's in such a wonderful, idyllic location and has everything you need on the inside for making it a very functional home. Not the largest, of course, it is a cottage, so you're not going to be looking at, you know, manor-esque interiors, but it has all the basics, plenty of storage, all the crafting, and of course, a nice cozy bed for you to go and have a sleep in. So let's take a look at what all we do get here, and first off, let's take a look at where exactly you find it. Now, as mentioned, it is south of the Half Moon Mill, just to the southwest, in between it and the Evergreen Grove. And as you can see, we do get a handy-dandy little map marker here, so you can fast travel back to this home whenever you do need to store things, take a rest, etc. Now, on to how you get your hands on this thing. Well, when you bring it into the game, you'll find that on the door to this beautiful cottage is a note that's been stabbed on in there, and it's basically a notice saying that the previous tenant had died and the deed and keys have been transferred to Hearn over at the Half Moon Mill. And you'll specifically find them in their lockbox on the inside there. So you will have to steal that, but you know what? Well worth it for this gorgeous home. Now, with key and deed in hand, you can just head on in and open the door, and you'll be greeted by the main floor. Again, like I mentioned, it's a pretty small cottage interior, so on the main floor is where you're gonna have your kitchen, dining room area, and also a lovely little reading nook. Now, after that, we go up a lovely set of spiral stairs that'll head into the top floor, where you have your bedroom and sort of the bulk of your storage within this cottage. Now, the only thing left on the main sort of upper level of the building is the tower, where it has a nice chair and a gorgeous view of the lake and the Half Moon Mill in the distance. Now, heading on back outside, we actually have a cellar door you can open up to go into, well, the cellar, where it has the bulk of the crafting stations in there, such as a forge for you to use. So you've got all the basic necessities. You've got crafting stations, storage, seating, bed, and, well, not exactly a necessity, but a gorgeous view from on top of that tower. So let's take a look at everything in more detail and take a gander at the exterior first. And as someone who makes a lot of potions in this game, I love that we just have all over the place tons of flowers for you to harvest. And if we actually head over to the side of the building here, well, we have a nice little wood chopping block for any firewood you may need. Here is where the door to the cellar is, and we'll actually go take a look at that in a second since, you know, it's nice and convenient outside. And if you continue on to the back of the building here, we got a little wooden gate we can open, and we've actually got chickens! It's quite nice over here. You got a lovely little chicken nest here, so you can pick up some eggs, some more flowers, fungi, etc. Just a nice little place. Nothing exactly too special about it, but, you know, I quite like that. Just a neat little extra detail of some chickens in your backyard. Now, before heading on to the main inside, let's go ahead and check out the cellar since we are right here. And like I mentioned, this is where you're going to get the primary crafting area for yourself. You've got a grindstone, you've got the workbench, you've got the full blacksmith's forge. No tanning in here, which I would have thought that would be in this locale, but no, we do not have that. We do have a little bit of storage, though, with this cupboard, which is pretty good. And, of course, a sack that for some reason, don't know why, is actually a steal. This is our home now. I've got the deed and key. Why that is? I don't know. But all right, well, let's head back on out of the cellar. Not too much to talk about there. It's just a nice little crafting area. And let's head on inside of the house where, oh boy, that knife is still there, but the letter has disappeared. Good times, good times. Oh, well. Now, on inside, as mentioned, we come into the main kitchen, dining room, and reading nook, which I quite love. And you can see there are a lot of static objects in this home all throughout, and you saw some of them downstairs in the cellar, but in the home, you get a lot of things like all these potions, books, which are there purely for decoration. You cannot loot them, including like this bow and quiver of arrows here. They are just there to look good. And look good, they very much do. Now, if we start on the left-hand side here, we do have, for usability, a nice little cooking pot, so you can do your cooking here in the home. And besides the static objects scattered around, there actually are a couple of non-static objects, like the juniper berries here, got a salt pile, a sack, which isn't steel, thankfully, for any storage of cooking things, and we do also have a nice little mortar and pestle there. What a lovely dining room table with a couple of rustic chairs for you to sit in and enjoy your meal. A nice little wood-burning heater here, which, you know, again, can't actually interact with nor with the stuff on the shelf, but just a nice little beautiful detail. Though I honestly think my favorite area is this corner here. Not only do we have the weird glowy thing, but a just gorgeous little extra area here. You can take a seat, read a book if you'd so desire, and it'd be wonderful. I would kill for a home with a lovely little place like this to sit in. It's just cozy and wonderful. Now, there are a few little weird lighting texture issues that I seem to have. It's, I think, mainly because of my lantern mod that I have installed. If I turn that off, you know, this is the sort of brightness you get in here, and with the lantern on, well, some of the things you can see, like the stone on the fireplace, doesn't quite like it, but yeah, I think that's more because of my lantern mod than anything else. But just in case you notice a few weird issues with that, I do think that's on my end. Now, we do, of course, have these lovely sets of doors here, which we open on up to the spiral staircase, and this is that main tower that you saw outside. Now, at the bottom, we do have the, I personally would call this the primary storage, a nice large chest for us to put crap into, but, of course, as you saw with the sack over there and the cupboard downstairs, there are also other bits of storage around. And if we head on up the spiral staircase, we come into the main bedroom, where if we close this, just take a look at everything. We do have a lovely wardrobe here, an end table for more storage, as well as another chest. And then again, just a lot of nice static items all over our desk here, our bookshelf back there. There is one book that is actually takeable, the tome of Metamorphosis, which does serve as a container for you to put in your enchantments, etc. It's pretty neat there. And we do actually have some actual soul gems down here. I figured those would be perhaps static objects at first, but no, they are in fact full-on soul gems. Now, everything else in this room is just, you know, pretty much static items. We do have a nice little bed here. Oh, I actually forgot. Yeah, we have a little box of, like, juniper berry mead and such over here. Very nice. And, yeah, just some other really gorgeous decorations. It's just a lovely, cozy little home. Now, if we go on up to the top of the tower, where, you know, I'm hoping it's gone by now. It's probably not, though. Oh, yeah, kind of gone. Yeah, I don't know why, but there was an Imperial soldier dead up here who still seems to be here, but invisible. I don't think that's part of the mod. I'm pretty sure it's just a weird glitch of something that occurred in my game. But overall, this tower up here is just magnificent. I love, we've got a cool seat here where you can look out at the Half Moon Cottage, the stream, the mountains, the lake. It is just a magnificent view. And like with the lovely little nook downstairs, I would kill for a view like this at my home. Instead, I've to see other townhouses and some trees, but you know, hey, it works. And yeah, just all in all, this Half Moon Cottage is a gorgeous little place. I really do love it. Not only the location is pretty nice and easy to get to, it looks beautiful along the stream. The house itself is quite well made with all the things you could require. And considering the size, I actually quite like home mods that are about this size. The ones that are larger, like full-on gigantic castles, I don't really tend to care for as much because it's just a bit too much room. But overall, it's just a beautiful, cozy little cottage. And if you would like to have a look at this place for yourself, which I would certainly recommend you go and do, you can have a look at the link in the description, as per usual, my friends. But that is going to be it for this episode today. Hopefully you all have enjoyed, and you do come back for the next episode, when we'll be looking at yet another wonderful mod, hopefully. But until that time, thank you for watching, and as always, have a good one!